My name is Rajkumar Ramachandran, and I come from a Hindu family. I'm the youngest of five children, and I was born in Bombay and grew up in Chennai. And from the age of 11, I began to seek after God. I believe there's a God and I want to know him. And our family, we were all religious people. My mother and I were very religious, whereas my siblings and my dad were not so religious, but they believed in God. And we were actually Ayyars, Tamil Brahmins. Ayyar is followers of Shiva, whereas followers of Vishnu are called Ayyangars. And although it didn't make much difference to me, the fact that I was from a Brahmin family, I was seeking after the God who created me. And I believe there is a God. I knew about God, but did not know God. I look at the creation and I believe there's a God who created all these things. But I didn't know him. I knew about him. From the age of 11, I used to seek after this God. I go to the terrace of my house in Chennai, lie flat on the ground, look at the stars and wonder who made those stars. And I would talk to the one who made the stars. I want to know who you are. And then I used to do all the rituals. I used to go to temples, do pujas with my mother. Everything went well in my life. I was fairly good in studies, but very good in sports. I was a cricket player for Tamil Nadu State Schools. I was an athlete. And I thought, because I am faithful to going to temples and praying to God almost every day, my God has been good to me. And being the youngest of five children, I was pampered by everybody. So really, I didn't have any apparent needs in life. Everything was provided for. But in my heart, there was a hunger for God. I finished my schooling in Don Bosco School in Chennai. 1 year engineering college, one year I did Loyola College, I did PUC. And then 5 years I studied engineering, electronics and telecommunication engineering. And everything went well in my life. I got a job very quickly. The second job I applied for, I got in a company called Siemens in Bangalore. And in 1974, I passed out of engineering college and got a job in Siemens in Bangalore. We were five young engineers, all unmarried, all bachelors, good friends. We were working in a manufacturing unit in Bangalore, manufacturing power line carrier communication equipment. Good friends. And one of them was a Christian. And after a few years of working, 3-4 years of working together, one day he told me, "Raj, I know you're a religious person. You believe in God. But I want to tell you something. 2 years I want to tell you, but I hesitated. Now I'm going to tell you." He says, "God loves you." I said, "I know that." "Jesus loves you." I said, "I know that also. Because I believe in Jesus also among so many gods. In Hinduism, we have so many gods, 330 million gods. 330 million plus one more Jesus is no problem to believe." So I also believe in Jesus. Then he said something very, in a nice way, but a little provoking. He said, "There's only one way to God, and that is Jesus. And the gods you are serving, you are worshipping, are not gods." And I got very upset, because from the age of 11, when I prayed to various gods and goddesses, my prayers were answered. I had my prayers answered. My life was a happy life. And I said, "You can't say that. How can you say that there's only one way to God and that is Jesus?" And I thought this guy is wrong. He's a very good friend of mine, very nice person, wonderful person. We all respected him. But I thought, in this aspect, he's wrong. He can't say there's only one way to go to heaven. So I will prove him wrong. I won't fight with him. I won't argue with him. I will prove to him there are many ways of going to heaven. How do I do that? I decided I will buy a Bible. And from the Bible, I'll prove to him there are many ways of going to heaven. Till that point of time, I used to pray long prayers, half an hour sometimes, 45 minutes sometimes. But that day onwards, I decided I will stop all my prayers. I'll pray to the living God, whoever he is, living God, and ask him, "Is Christ the only way to you?" If it is so, let me know. If it's not so, also let me know. So my prayer time reduced from half an hour to 15 seconds. And I opened the Bible, began to read. I didn't know anything about the Bible. I never read the Bible before. And I thought the Bible has two parts. I knew the Bible has two parts, Old Testament and New Testament. Old Testament is old, New Testament is new. So I will read the New Testament, and from the New Testament, I'll prove to him there are many ways of going to heaven. So I began my experiment with God. So on the first day, I opened the Bible in the night and said, Living God, show me, is Christ the only way? It so happened the very first page before me was Gospel of John, chapter 1, verse 1, where it's written, In the beginning was the Word was with God, the Word was God. Found very, very interesting, very philosophical. It appealed to my Hindu philosophical mind. The beginning was the Word was with God, the Word was God. How can both be true? How can he be with God and God at the same time? Began to think, kept on reading, came to the 14th verse. The 14th verse says, And the Word became flesh and dwelt amongst us. How can the Word become flesh? I found the Bible very interesting. As I kept on reading, I began to read about the life of Jesus. How compassionate he was, the things he taught, the way he was so compassionate with the woman caught in adultery, in the 8th chapter of John. And I thought, what an amazing person he is. Loving, compassionate, kind, profound teaching. And I thought, amazing person this Jesus is. As I would read the Bible every day in the night, I got so engrossed in the Bible, I forgot why I began the Bible. I began the Bible to prove my friend wrong. But I got so engrossed in the Bible that I forgot why I began. And as I read the Bible, everything went well. My day went well, my work went well. Everything seemed to fall in place simply by reading the Bible and enjoying it. Everything went well till I came to the 14th chapter of John. I got stuck in verse 6. In John 14, 6, Jesus says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. That verse hit me like a thunderbolt. Jesus is saying, He is the way. If a Christian says that, I may not believe. But Jesus himself is saying that. And even as a Hindu, I believe him to be true, holy, right, pure, in fact, God. Here he is saying, He is the only way. I could not come to terms with the statement of Jesus. I closed the Bible. Could not read any further. And I thought, I can't proceed further unless I understand this verse. For a month and a half, I didn't read the Bible. But every night, this thought would come to me. Jesus says, He is the way. What do you say to what He says? I had no answer. After a month and a half, I thought, as long as I read the Bible, everything went well in my life. My day went well. My work went well. Ever since I stopped, something was missing. And I stopped because of John 14:6. Let me forget about John 14:6 and continue John 14:7. So after a month and a half, I opened the Bible. I tried not to look at John 14:6 and read John 14:7. In John 14:7, Jesus says, If you really knew me, you'll know my Father as well. From now onwards, you know him and have seen him. And the Bible began to speak to me. So as if God is sitting next to me and teaching me. Nobody was in the room. Alone I used to read the Bible. And I thought, this Bible is speaking to me. Let me put questions to God. I would tell the living God, you are a God of infinite wisdom. My wisdom is very small. I cannot know everything that you know. But I'm going to put my questions to you. I'm going to put my questions to you. If you feel I can understand the answer, give me the answer. If you feel I cannot understand, then don't give me the answer. So I put a question and purposely forget that question. Because I thought, if God doesn't answer my question, why remember it? I'll keep on putting questions and forgetting the questions. What used to happen was, as I would read the Bible, he would first give me the answer from the Bible. And after giving me the answer, he would remind me of my question. In 1 year's time, every question was answered. I remember one very well-known question, which I had, which I gave it to him. I said, Lord, living God, I was told from childhood, there's something called reincarnation. Again, again, we have to be born again. What is the truth? Is it really true? Living God, tell me. I forgot about it. I'm reading the book of Hebrews, chapter 9, verse 27. Hebrews 9, 27. There it says, just as man is destined to die once and then face judgment, Christ died once for sins of many people. He'll come again, not to bear sin, but to bring salvation for those waiting for him. Answer was given. After 1 year of testing God, I had no questions after that. In the meantime, I got transferred to Germany. My wife was, I had already got married. My wife was also a Hindu Brahmin like me. She was in Chennai. And then I went to Munich in Germany. We were living in Bangalore. When I came to Germany, she went to Chennai to be with her parents. And for some time, then came back and joined my dad in Bangalore. And when I went to Germany, after 1 year, God began to speak so clearly to me, every question was answered. So on the 25th of May, 1980, at 9:30 p.m., I accepted Christ into my heart as Savior and Lord. I knew He is my Savior. So clear from the Bible. But something happened, in fact, many things happened before that. 6 months after I began my experiment with God, one day in Bangalore, when I was in the office, lunchtime, a man walked into my office. He was an astrologer. He looked at my face. And looking at my face, he very clearly told me, many years ago, you had an accident in which you almost died. Within 1 month, you'll have one more accident and you might die. Normally, I won't believe such people. But 8 years earlier, I almost got drowned in a swimming accident in the Himalayas. I'd gone for a trekking program. I and my friends were swimming across a mountain stream. I got caught in a whirlpool. I was being sucked inside. Few more seconds, I would have drowned. But someone pulled me out of the water. And because the astrologer told me correctly after so many years, correctly about my past, when he said, in 1 month's time, we have one more accident, I thought it'll happen. Because he seemed to know everything about me, my past. 1 month's time, electric shock or road accident, and you might die. I was so scared. That night, for the first time in my life, I called upon the name of Jesus. I said, Jesus, if you are there, I want to tell you, I'm very scared of what this man told me. I'm having fear of death. And ensure that this accident doesn't take place and remove this fear of death. Before I could finish my prayer, the fear left. Extraordinary peace came upon me. Only 6 months later, I actually gave my life to Christ. And when I accepted Christ on 25th of May, 1980, I was so excited. And then I said, Lord, all these years, no one told me about Jesus. I went to Christian school, Christian college, except my friend in the office. Why no one told me about Jesus? It's so obvious from the Bible, He's the only Savior. And the Lord kept quiet. By keeping quiet, He asked me a question. You were saying no one told you all these years. Now you know, what will you do? He said, Lord, I can't keep quiet. And next day morning began my ministry of evangelism. Now, within a few days or maybe 1 or 2 weeks later, in a matter of time, the Lord showed me promises in the Bible to which He had been faithful when I was a Hindu. I did not even know Him. He showed me Romans 10:13. Everyone who calls upon the name of the Lord will be saved. Saved means delivered. When I had the fear of death, fear of accident, I called upon Jesus' name and He delivered me. He showed me that verse, the promise. Then he showed me Hebrews chapter 2, 14, 15. Since the children have flesh and blood, he too share in their humanity. So that by his death, he will destroy the one who holds the power of death and free those who all their lives were held in slavery by their fear of death. He showed me that 2,000 years ago, he delivered mankind from the fear of death, coming to the world and hanging on a cross. By his death, he destroyed the devil who held the power of death. Then the Lord showed me Isaiah 43:2, where it says, Isaiah 43:2, when you pass through the waters, I will be with you. When you pass through the rivers, they will not sweep over you. Went back to 8 years earlier, in that river in the Himalayas, I was about to get drowned. The Lord was with me. Then I realized, Lord, I didn't know your promises. I didn't know you. But you were faithful to your promises to me. You knew me. I didn't know you. And not only you are faithful to me, you're faithful to your promises. I didn't even know the promise. I didn't even know you. Now when I know you, and if I know your promises, how much more I can face every crisis in life. So for the last 40 years, it's been my privilege to live for him, not only have the assurance of eternal life, but also having an abundant life in this world, abundance of peace, abundance of joy, freedom from anxiety, no anxiety at all, because God says, I have the best plans for you, plans to prosper you, not to harm you, to give a hope and a future. Jeremiah 29:11. And also the God who encourages us always, always encourages us. So all these years I've been living by the word of God and holding on to God's promises and rising above every situation in life. In the book of Romans chapter 5 verse 17, Romans 5, 17 is written, if by the trespass of one man, death reigned to that one man, that's Adam, how much more will those who receive God's abundant provision of grace and the gift of righteousness reign in life through one man, Christ Jesus. Reigning in life. Reigning over every problem in life. The world has problems. The Lord never said, you follow me, you won't have problems. In fact, he promises problems. In John 16:33, Jesus says, John 16:33. I have told you these things, that in me you will have peace. In the world you will have troubles, but take heart, I have overcome the world. It's a joyful life, abundant life, assurance of salvation. I know today when I die, I'll go to heaven because by his blood, he has cleansed me of every sin. That's why he's the only way. Sinless life he lived, offered his body on the cross as a payment for the sins of the whole world. And then 1 month after I accepted Jesus, the Lord asked me a question. Will you go where I send you? Will you speak what I put in your heart? I said, Lord, I can't say no to you. Yes, I will go. And looking back all these 40 years, he has taken me to 49 countries of this world, 28 states of India, except Tripura, I've been to all the states. Tripura also I'll go maybe next year. And I've seen thousands of people call upon that name and be saved. It's a privilege for me to share this testimony with you because what God did in my life, not I did. It's all about what he did. I'm only sharing what he has done for me, what he can do for anybody when you give your life to him, because God shows no favoritism. He loves everybody. His compassion and love is all he has made. May God bless every one of you as you take the claims of Jesus very, very seriously and live for him as his disciple. Because he said in John 8:12, I am the light of this world. He who follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. May God bless you. It is a privilege to share this testimony with you for his glory and for our edification. God bless you.